Jesus, for holding us in your hands. Thank you, Jesus, for holding us, for never letting us down.
December, today 17th of December, we are bringing together the best among our preachers in Nigeria.
As others go to Jerusalem,
God is about to do something for them. They will not come here and go without a blessing. They will not come here and go without a child. Number two, everyone who comes from the family where they have financial crisis, they rise up and they collapse. They collect money and the money vanishes. Next week, as they will come out to dance before this awesome God, let that be the change of their story. Let destiny helpers be sent their way. And let their story change. And this Christmas shall be the greatest Christmas ever. Where their parents have no house, may they start building a house this week, this month, this year. Where there is lack, let there be supplies of money. Let the miracle begin. For I ask in Jesus' name. Today is a good day. I have Wait. I have 192,000 for our best performance this night. The lady that led the choir, I don't know if my eyes are seeing properly. She looks pregnant. Is she pregnant? And she sang with that pregnancy. Madam Uma, come and give her 20,000 naira. Come, my daughter, do I know you? You are who? Huh? Pastor? What is the man we're talking about? Okay, come. Is she pregnant again? Abed, count out brand new notes, 20,000 for her. Pregnancy will not stop you from singing. Madam, do you need prayer? There were a quartet, three girls who danced from here. I don't know if they know who they are. Can you please come out? There were four of them, just all girls. They danced in, that's one of them. Good. How did you know I had four of them in mind? Come, the blue girl. You are not one of them, go back. No. Is that your red blue? I'm talking about this one. 1, 2, 3, 4 of you. You, go back to your seat. Give them 10,000. Come, you, are you a visitor? I thought so. I've not seen you before. There were three men who danced together this night and made me happy. No, you are not one of them. Come, are you friends, three of you? Huh? This one is your friend. This one is not. Madam, give them 10,000. Whatever Satan has brought your way to stop you from being happy, I want you to hear me, whether Satan likes it or not, you owe yourself happiness. Continue to dance for this great God, and He will bless you abundantly well. We are going to give to two more people. Madam, come back. Where are you going? Are you protesting? We have this old man. I don't know where he gets the energy. Give him 10,000. We have another very, very consistent lady. She dances every Wednesday with every energy she can muster. She's fair in complexion. She's wearing a red cap today. Where is she? No, not you. She. Oh yeah. Give her 10,000. New notes. I don't know whether you know, this money we give from time to time was discussed in London. There was a man that came from London to be part of a miracle convention. He gave a message. He said he was surprised we were giving money instead of clapping for people. I asked him to practice it. He said, no, they don't have the kind of money we have. So he will not practice it, but will clap for people. Here, we want you to know, this God can translate your blessings into money.
And you watching to bong bimbo. I'm you, mammy queen.
And you watching to Jehovah. I'm you, mammy queen.
Wait. We had a drummer this night. Oga drummer, can you come and collect 10,000? Madam, come back. No, how many of you are drummers here? You are the drummer. This man. Huh? His name is Bright. Bring your drum, let me see. Who is this man? Huh? Talking drum. What's the difference? Okay. I didn't plan for two of you to win, but now that you're here, you are all winners. Give them 10,000. Do you know, next week may be your turn. Come, wait, madam. Let them go and bring their drums. Take back the money. Let him go and bring the drum. Let us hear the drum talk. What? Is the big drum? Ah. Why are they speaking for you? Okay, give him. Let him take and go. I don't know whether you know there will be a reward in heaven. Yes, there will be a reward in heaven. And some of us have already begun to practice for that day. But let us say to God, there is none like you. Then our brethren, my wife says she's now 75 years old. I am already going to 80. I have never seen any God like our God. I quarreled with one of your presidents and I said to him, hey, old boy, before this time you will no more be president and the God I preach will arrest you. He said, oh man, you're just not only stupid, you're bragging. 4 days, they came and arrested him. I met another man and said to him, Governor, for insulting me, in 3 months' time, you will never be governor again. The God I preach will kick you out of this office. He said, you are bluffing and stupid. That one I know. My mother told me long time ago that I was stupid. Now you have confirmed it. 3 months after, I don't know where Abacha came from. He sacked all of them across the board. The day I saw the man again in Benin, he said, oh man, others use the anointing for healing. You use your own to sack governors. It shall not be well with you. God will punish you and punish you and punish you 10 times. Oh God, take it. Take it easy, because even God is not listening to you. You are not one of his children. And you are watching to be a member.
Thank you.
beautiful young girl. Bring her. Madam Uma, come and give her 10,000. Who was playing the lead guitar? Huh? Bobby. Madam, give him. He was able to bring out the tune I wanted. So give him also 10,000. This girl, has she any name? Who knows her name? The one you're carrying, she's asking me who. Are you also a baby? Huh? Delight. Is that her real name? Delight. What of her Vadakola name? Adani. Okay. Tell her one day she will dance at the world stage. Give him 10,000. I want everybody to take your seats and bring out your Bible. Please, no more noise making. The miracle of next week starts this night. And there are about 32 people here that God will heal and bless. The miracle shall not only be healing, it shall be permanent. Surplus supplies of money. I have had it for 70 years now, and the same God can do it for you. Let's go to the book of Exodus chapter 3, verse 21. Write it down in your notebook, mark it in your Bible, and please listen attentively and intently and earnestly to me. But God will speak through my voice to you. And God will say something you have never heard before. And this night shall be the beginning of your greatness. Yes, sir.
Exodus 3:21. And I will give these people favor.
I want you to write down the word favor. Right where you're sitting tonight, there's a promise from heaven to you that God will bless your life with favor. But what type of favor? Let's go to the book of Luke chapter 2 verse 52. Yes, sir.
And Jesus increased in wisdom.
Not decreased. Increased.
Increased in wisdom.
Right where you are this night, God can also increase you in wisdom. Yes, sir.
And stature.
And stature.
And in favor with God and man.
Men and brethren, I want you to look up and look at me. There's what I call favor with God and man. Where I live, I did not really pay for it. A man I led to Christ became governor. He came to you one day looking for me, and he was told I was a tenant to a man. And he said, not in this life. This man is my father in the Lord. I am not the governor of the state, so he cannot be a tenant to anybody. The man sent for me. I went with my wife. He said, I was shocked to hear you are a tenant. I'll give you a house. And I said to him, Your Excellency, I'm not looking for a house because Jesus will soon come and we shall be raptured out of this ugly world. My wife said, I have something to say. Madam, when your husband has spoken, it is final. She said, no, I have something to say. I am also waiting for the rapture. But I don't want to be raptured from another man's house, but from my own house. Madam, you decrease. The governor said to us, Daddy, take her to the house of estate in you. And let her point out, show any house of her choice. I will pay. That's what we call favor with man. Right where you're sitting tonight, I declare this night the beginning of your favor with man and with God. One of the things God has come out to do for me, He has helped me to find favor in His sight. You know, I think 2 weeks ago we were burying my cousin, you know, in a village in Asaga, and it threatened to rain, and the rain began to pour. I picked the microphone and said to the rain, hey, can you stop that nonsense? I am your senior brother. When 2 of us are on duty, sent by the same master, you give me the honor of being your senior brother and allow me to finish preaching before you rain. You know the rain stopped. I am not asking God to bless him with favor. I am asking God to bless him with favor with man and with God. No, I want you to understand, the two are not the same. The week God asked me to resign my appointment and come to you and become a full-time preacher, I didn't know students of University of Ife were already in Uyo waiting for me. Arrival, they gave me the microphone to preach, and suddenly it rained cats and dogs. And God said to me, this rain is your funeral, brother. Speak. I'm talking about what happened in 1972. And I said to the rain, I am your senior brother. Can you please give me honor and space? Let me finish preaching before you come back. The rain stopped immediately, instantly. Professor Una, who sat next to me, asked me, Uma, how can God obey a small boy like you? You're a small boy. I am older than you. Oh, God. It has nothing to do with age. He said, no, take this back. Whatever you see in this bag is yours. For God to honor a small boy like you, I also will honor you. When I opened the bag, it contained my 6 month salary where I was working in Calabar. That man could have ignored me. That man could have just ignored me. But no, that's what we call favor with man and favor with God. Right where you are sitting tonight, I want you to start a new journey with God. May you find favor with Him and favor in the sight of men. For a man to bring out the type of money that man brought out to buy a house for us remains a puzzle to me till today. A man who was a house boy in New York came to me and said, I am tired of being a house boy. I have saved my 7 brothers as the house boy, and I have continued to save more. When will this end? I don't even know the detail of our discussion. But after my prayer, and as I speak today, he later became a senator. His friend came to me and said, I also want to be blessed. Let your prayer life bless me. He has that second friend now has 3 refineries across the world. And he brought me 2 Range Rover Jeeps in 1 week. But that is no good news, because it takes $1 million to service a Range Rover Jeep. It takes $3,500,000 to change the engine. It changed 116,000 naira to change the side mirror. So anybody who gives you a Range Rover has not really blessed you. Huh? Don't worry, God who allowed rashes to come on your skin will also find nails to scratch the rashes. But it's not, when you see a man with Range Rover, don't envy him. Pity him. A man drove into my side mirror, a professor from University of Uyo. I looked at him. I know him. And I said, hey, go on, don't worry about the side mirror, I'll replace it. He said, no, sir. That side mirror is very expensive. I will not go unless you open your mouth and ask God not to punish me. So I said, Father, don't punish him. Let him go free. I drove to the workshop where they repair and change that side mirror. And they said to me, bring 116,000. What? What is the man that crashed my... You know, the man had gone. But God has a way of picking your bills. Soon after, a woman came from Oka and said to me, do you know they have locked up my husband in the boot of their car for 54 days now. If that man dies, I will kill myself. And I said to her, no, they will release him on Monday. She asked me, how did you know? Hey, shut up your mouth. He who employed me and sent me to you can speak through me. On Monday, your husband will be free. She called the man in that boot of the car and said to him, on Monday, you'll be free. And the man said, if I am free, I'll give whoever brought me out 5 million naira. On Monday, he was released. On Monday, he came here. And that was the day I was going to service that Range Rover Jeep. And I needed good money. The man came. But then I cried. He was a tall, elegant, handsome, fair complexion young man. Of about 6 feet tall. Okay, how did they squeeze into the boot? He said, not only did they squeeze me into the boot, but they were stealing with me in their car. As the bullets came flying, I cried and asked God, is this the end? 2 of us cried together. Don't ask me if he gave me the money. But I repaired the car. That's what God does for us. Read on, sir. We are back to the book of Exodus. Let's take the next line. What does it say?
And I'll give these people favor.
I'll give, wherever you go, tell yourself, I carry the favor with God and with man everywhere I go. Can you say it after me? The first day I came to Uyo, I got to Uyo Uyo Moto Park, and that was DJ Ma seated at the entry point. He said, Uma, I know you. Hey, Oga, you don't know me. I am coming to you for the first time. He said, no, last night, God gave me your picture. God gave me your name. I know you. And God asked me to prepare a beautiful residential home for you. The house is ready. Can we go from here to the house? I am going to ask God to give you the same favor. This God must be part of your life. And evidence shall speak of God's power. And evidence shall be visible. Wow. Can you raise your hand and shout hallelujah 2 times? Odigonye yiri ya. Odigonye yiri gi. Odigonye yiri tineke kenibe. Odigonye geji maya to somo ya yiri ya. Change his mind and make me the leader, I don't know. I went to preach in my brother's church. He said to his pastor, I cannot sit on the same platform with this man. My father preferred him over me, so let me join the crowd while he sits with you. I cried that day. For reasons I don't know, the story of your life has changed this night. It has changed. It has changed. It has changed. It has changed. Raise your hand and shout hallelujah 3 times. Hallelujah. I declare tonight you're going to have favor with God and with man. When my uncle drove me out of our family house, a distant uncle sent for me and he invited all his children. We all gathered together, not knowing what was going to say to us. And the man said to his children, whatever money you are owing me, give it to man, that he may not suffer. His uncle had driven him away from their house, but I will take care of him and make him a man. Me, the most successful man who had a car, beautiful picture, said to me, Uma, I will take you from here and give you a good job in Oki, oil palm estate. I'll take care of you. For everybody that will pay you a salary, I'll drive you to Enugu for you to pay in that money to an account. I'll drive you myself. For unfortunately for me, I was taller than the man. Every time police stopped, they said to me, hey, tell your driver to park well. And my uncle would say, before I slap you, tell him you are not the one. Wow, father, so what do I owe this? Right where you are standing this night, there is a shift in the spiritual realm for you. This God says you have favor with God and with man. Maybe I can even add, you have favor with principalities. In Gombe, we sang a song and a blind woman fell under the anointing and her eyes opened. Boko Haram boys got angry and came with their guns to shoot me. As they pulled the trigger would just say, Bob, I will not fire. Bob, I will not fire. That means even the God favored me. Mama, what you hear where Jesus? Odigi hey, Koramale.
Mama,
what you hear where Jesus? Odigi hey, Koramale. Mama, what
you hear where Jesus? Odigi hey, Koramale. Mama, what you hear where Jesus? Odigi hey, Koramale.
Mama, what you hear where Jesus? Odigi hey, Koramale. So they give a coronal money. We'll be right back. Because I have Jesus, I have everything. Wow. Can we see the book of John, chapter 1, verse 12? What does it say?
As many as received him, gave him power.
To them he gave power. Go on, to be sons of God. And to do what others cannot do. Right where you are, if you are already a born again child of God, you don't need any other thing to add. That's more than enough. Wow. You can do whatever Jesus did. And right where you're sitting tonight, you are not an ordinary person. No, stand up and say to two people, I am not an ordinary person. We are back to the book of Luke chapter 2 verse 52. What does it say? Yes, sir.
Jesus increased in wisdom.
He increased in wisdom. And tonight, beginning tonight, you will increase in wisdom. I don't know if you know what wisdom can do. It opens every closed door against you. Read on, sir.
And in favor with God and man.
I want you to hear me. Your favor is not only with God, you also have favor with man. When Jigema said to me, Brother Uma, God asked me to design a house and build a house for you. The house is ready. Can we go to that house? You know, I cried. I didn't know the man from Adam. I have never done anything for him. He said, the house is great. You know, I lived there for many years. And right where you are sitting tonight, your favor shall not be only with God. It shall also be with man. Whoever will give you his daughter to marry will love you also. Whoever can wipe away your tears shall wipe away your tears. Why? Because you have favor with God and with who? Us. Somebody asked me, the man that gave you 2 chips, what did you do for him? Let's not discuss it. Just thank God I have 2 jeeps. Read on. We are back to... Move on. Let's go back to chapter 3 of the book of Exodus. Let's take verse 22.
But every woman shall borrow of her neighbor.
No. Okay, go on.
Verse 21.
21 and 22.
And I will give these people favor.
I'll give the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians. In the sight of those who don't like you. Wow. Right where you are seated tonight, I declare, you are no longer an ordinary person. Yes, sir.
And it shall come to pass,
that
when ye go,
when you go,
ye shall not go empty.
Right where you are sitting tonight, I speak as your prophet. You no longer go through life empty-handed. I have told this story before. We're coming back from Enugu, driving towards Uma here. And God said to me, there's a man ahead of you. He has no money and no food in his car. Give him 100,000 naira. As I was chasing the man, he was speeding to run away from me. He thought I was an armed robber. Hey, foolish man, I am not an armed robber. I'm bringing you money. He asked me, from who? I said, from God. Oh, he knows I have no money. Park your car and collect the money. When you see him, you ask him, did you know I had no money? There are many this God will send to you. A young man in America called Pastor Joe to say, tell Papu Man, I have no father. I want him to be my father. I'll take care of him till the day he will die. Up to now, I said to the man, put that promise aside until the right time. Right where you are, this God has promised, as you go through life, you will not go through life empty-handed. Poverty is a cross. Can you raise up your hand and say, beginning tonight, as I go through life, I shall not go empty-handed. Why don't we say to this God, you're the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah.
Circumstances together and will throw you up. You will not come down again. Read on, sir.
And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, for the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships.
He entered into one of the ships,
which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out,
and pleaded with him that he would thrust out
little
the boat
from the land. And he sat down, and taught the people out of the ship. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon,
wait, we are preparing for the miracle convention. We are looking for men that shall give us their boats, that Jesus may sit on that boat and preach. And if he will give that boat this night, what happened to Peter will happen to you. I don't know if you know what it means to sit upon a boat and preach the good news. Where we shall begin the miracle convention, we are going to speak to thousands, hundreds of thousands of people. And all those that shall make available to us and to Jesus their boats, they shall be blessed beyond measure. It shall be the end of their struggling and poverty. You know, they would ride from there. Okay, go to verse 8. Run to verse 8.
Verse 8. When Simon Peter saw it.
When Simon Peter saw what Jesus had done.
He fell down at Jesus'
feet.
Saying, Depart from me. For I am a sinful man. For he was astonished.
He was astonished.
And all that were with him at the drought of the fishes which they had taken.
The drought of the fishes they took. Men and brethren, was something they never imagined could happen. Right where you are, we are preparing for the miracle convention. And all those who will give Jesus their boats, they will be rewarded. They will be blessed. Jesus will appoint them the general superintendent of the Church of God worldwide. That's what he did for Peter. And therefore this night I'm asking, is there anybody here that will say to God, I'll give you 100,000 naira for the miracle convention? I have given 5 million. And on Friday, I'll give again another 5 million. That will be 10 million. But do I have anybody here who can say to Jesus, I'll give 100,000 naira that you may preach from my boat to your people? Stand up and come here. I'm going to pray for you. The miracles we are talking about shall begin with you. Come quickly. Abawa Lamaka. Onyewigwe Abawa Lamaka. Ibene Chendo Abawa Lamaka. Anomiruge. Onyewe Mnorolu.
Abawa Lamaka. Abawa Lamaka. Abawa Lamaka. Anomiruge.
Abawa Lamaka.
Abawa Lamaka.
Heaven shall open for you. We are not collecting the money tonight. We are collecting the money between now and in 3 weeks' time. 100,000 naira cannot stop you from receiving what God has for you. Huh? We have only 500,000. Okay, one person says he will give 100,000. 500,000. Is a man here? Wow! What is the man? Give him a good clap up from somebody. You are the man. Good. Any other man? We're about to close. And I don't want poverty to follow you to the next year. This coming year shall be your year of new beginning. A year that things you could not do shall be done. I'm looking for 5 more people who can give us 100,000 in 2-3 weeks to come. Stand up and join them, and we shall close. That's one. Remaining 4. Who will give us that balance? There must be somebody here that needs God for a miracle. People you don't know shall bless you with money. People you have never seen shall bless you with money. And if you believe it shall be possible, stand up and join this crowd of successful people. How many? I think we have almost more. Give a clap offering to this great God. Father, whoever has stepped out in faith, as Peter offered his boat, and heaven above him opened, so let heaven above each of them now open. Let people they don't even know bless them. Let people they don't know pick up these bills. And Father, where they are today shall be the lowest place they will ever be. And let the miracle start. Father, let the miracle start. Everybody, fill out your platform. What popcorn? What do we have now? From the pledges they have paid, how much do we have now? Huh? Are they here? 87. They are more than 37. Yes, sir. Huh? Who? What did he say? 4. Okay. They said you have pledged 4.something million. But remember, I have also pledged 5 opinion. So we are on our way to greatness. The program shall hold. The crowd shall come. And miracles will happen. And many will see Jesus with their eyes. This night is your night of new beginning. Every one of you, raise up your hand. Father, as they go back to their seats, let doors open for them. All you said to Peter was, lower your net. You didn't even preach to him. You just said, lower your net. Can we all stand up? Everybody stand up. Father, we pledge our faith together. And we said, whatever we have said in our hearts today shall come to pass. That money shall be realized. This program shall hold. And miracles will happen. And whoever blocks our way shall be crushed. Father, let the miracle start. Let the impossible become possible. Wipe away the tears of your children. Let them know you can make the impossible possible. When Peter saw what you did, he knelt down and said, depart from me, for I am a sinner. Why? Because he was flabbergasted. Beginning tonight, whatever your children have pledged shall come to pass. Father, let this night be the night of new beginning. Let impossible things become possible. Amen. Father, we are preparing for our greatest program of the year, and great things shall happen. Amen. Father, it shall be so. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Please fill out your form and Father, whoever wants a miracle among your children now, give him or her that miracle. And you have spoken to me that there shall be 34 people that will go home with a testimony. Wherever they are, let the miracle start. Let it start. Let it start. Let it start. Let it start. All those that God has given a miracle, touched, spoken to, all those that God has visited, all those who have had this night as your night of divine visitation, and God has blessed and honored you, and God has done something in your life, can you please come to the altar? Just come out here, kneel down, and say to God, thank you. Just thank you, Father. Thank you. Children, stop noise making. Father, all those who are stepping out, let the past pass away. And let this night be the night of new beginning. Whatever they have been looking for shall now come looking for them. What they thought was impossible shall now become possible for them. Bless them with joy. Bless them with happiness. Father, this year shall be the greatest year in life. Nobody shall miss this miracle. Mighty God, thank you. Father, we bless you. Who is like you? There will never be any like you. Father, let this night be your people's night of new beginning. Father, let this night be the night of new beginning. It is done. And we rejoice in you, our God. We shall not return to that old place. The past has passed away. This night is a night of new beginning. It shall follow us to the new year. It shall be so. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Let's give the Lord a good clap of praise. Don't go. We want to count in a number. Pastor Joe, come and count them for me. Raise up your hand. Raise it above your head. Remember, we are now numbering you among the blessed of the Lord. And so you will be. Every stone thrown at you shall become your stepping stone to greatness. That stone will not hurt you. It shall not harm you. Because this night is the night of new beginning. The past is passed away. This night is the night of new beginning. Please change your attitude that you may change your life. How many do we have?
Hey, this is the entire fellowship.
Huh?
It's the entire fellowship.
What did you say?
Everybody came out. Yes, everybody came out.
Everybody is how many?
Well, we'll get the statistics from the ushering department where they give us.
Huh?
The ushering department will give us the number.
Where are the ushers? Come on, don't go. We want to count you. And if we count you, heaven shall count you. Have they gotten the number? How many?